Hi, welcome to Sunil Maths Tutorial, Vector Calculus, class number 20. In this class, we discuss about some theorems. Let us see the first one. Del cross of del cross A bar is equals to del of del dot A bar minus del square A bar, which is very, very important identity in vector calculus. So the first one, let us take LHS, del cross of del cross A bar. Let us take pi is equals to del cross A bar. Then this LHS takes the form del cross pi. What is the definition of del cross pi? This is nothing but curl of the vector. You see that. Del cross A bar. Del cross A bar. I bar cross dou A bar by dou x plus j bar cross dou A bar by dou y plus k bar cross dou A bar by dou z. This is nothing but summation I bar cross dou A bar by dou x. By applying this definition to this step del cross pi, you get summation I bar cross dou phi by dou x. Summation I bar cross dou phi by dou x. Again, I bar cross dou by dou x of what is pi? Del cross A bar. What is pi? Del cross A bar. Dou by dou x of del cross A bar. In the next step, we substitute del cross A bar. Here it is. Del cross A bar. I bar cross dou A bar by dou x plus j bar cross dou A bar by dou y plus k bar cross dou A bar by dou z. That is nothing but curl of A bar. Curl of A bar. We substitute that for term here. I bar cross dou A bar by dou x plus and so on. So dou by dou x of that term. Dou by dou x of that term. Let us differentiate every term. I bar cross dou by dou x of dou A bar by dou x. Dou square A bar by dou x square plus j bar cross dou by dou x of dou A bar by dou y, dou square A bar by dou x dou y, plus k bar cross dou by dou x of dou A bar by dou z, dou square A bar by dou x dou z. Observe that. Now split the terms means I bar is cross product with three terms. This is the first term and second term and third term. You have to product three terms with I bar, vector product or cross product. Let us simplify the term by term. So which is equals to summation I bar cross of I bar cross dou square A bar by dou x square plus I bar cross of j bar cross dou square A bar by dou x dou y plus I bar cross of k bar cross dou square A bar by dou x dou z. Observe that. Summation of every term. Summation of which is equals to summation. Observe the formula. In the previous class, we learned this formula. A bar cross of B bar cross C bar is equals to A bar dot C bar into B bar minus A bar dot B bar into C bar. A bar dot C bar into B bar. So by applying that condition, I bar dot dou square A bar by dou x square dot I bar minus I bar dot I bar into dou square A bar by dou x square plus this is the first term. This is the first term and let us see the second term. A bar dot C bar. I bar dot dou square A bar by dou x dou y into J bar minus I bar dot z bar into dou square A bar by dou x dou y. This is second term plus let us write the third term. Third term I bar dot dou square A bar by dou x dou z into k bar minus I bar dot k bar into dou square A bar by 2x 2z. Summation for all terms. Summation for all terms. There is a result, we know that. I bar dot I bar is equals to 1. I bar dot j bar is equals to 0. I bar dot k bar is equals to 0. By applying this result, this step takes the form, observe that. By applying that result, you get summation first term. I bar dot dou square a bar by dou x square into I bar. I bar dot I bar 1, so you get minus dou square a bar by dou x square plus, after first term, second term, I bar dot dou square a bar by dou x dou y into j bar. I bar dot j bar 0, so complete term becomes 0. I bar dot k bar 0, this term completely becomes 0, we get only this term, plus I bar dot dou square a bar by dou x dou z, dou square a bar by dou x dou z into k bar. You observe that I bar dot dou square a bar by dou x square, I bar minus dou square a bar by dou x square, this is the different term. And there is a similarity in all these three terms. Summation I bar dot dou square a bar by dou x square into I bar plus the next term I bar dot dou square a bar by dou x dou y, this is into j bar second term, I bar dot dou square a bar by dou x dou z into k bar minus, you can split the summation, it can be written as summation dou square a bar by dou x square. Let us rearrange these three terms. After rearranging the three terms, we get summation, you observe that I bar dot or the same term can be written as dou by dou x of I bar dot dou a bar by dou x into I bar plus dou by dou y into I bar dot dou a bar by dou x into j bar plus I bar dot dou a bar by dou x, I mean dou by dou z of I bar dot dou a bar by dou x into k bar minus, by removing the summation you get dou square a bar by dou x square. By removing the summation or by expanding the summation, you get dou square a bar by dou y square plus dou square a bar by dou z square. This is nothing but Laplacian operator. Yes, let us continue. Now you observe that if you put phi I bar dot dou a bar by dou x plus dou by dou y of I bar dot dou a bar by dou x plus dou by dou z of I bar dot dou a bar by dou x, if you replace some another function b bar by for this one, I bar dot dou a bar by dou x, I bar dot dou a bar by dou y and I bar dot dou a bar by dou x, if you replace phi with that function, this can be written as summation dou phi by, don't write phi, let us write psi, dou psi by dou x I bar plus dou psi by दो वाई जे बार प्लस दो साई बाई दो जेड के बार माइनस दिस इज नथिंग बट डेल स्क्वायर ए बार, डेल स्क्वायर ए बार विच इज नोन एज लाप्लासियन ऑपरेटर, लाप्लासियन ऑपरेटर डेल स्क्वायर ए बार. यू ऑब्जर्व दैट दिस इज नथिंग बट ग्रेड फाइव, दिस इज नथिंग बट ग्रेड फाइव समेशन, ग्रेड फाइव मीन्स डेल फाइव, डेल साई समेशन डेल साई माइनस डेल स्क्वायर ए बार, डेल स्क्वायर ए बार डेल समेशन साई मीन्स आई बार डॉट दो ए बार बाय दो एक्स, आई बार डॉट दो ए बार बाय दो एक्स. समेशन डज नॉट इंफ्लुएंस डेल, सो यू कैन राइट हियर डेल समेशन आई बार दो ए बार बाय दो एक्स माइनस डेल स्क्वायर ए बार. You observe that summation I bar dot dou a bar by dou x, summation I bar dot dou a bar by dou x, summation I bar dot dou a bar by dou x. If you expand this summation, you get I bar dot dou a bar by dou x plus z bar dot dou a bar by dou y plus k bar dot dou a bar by dou z. This is nothing but del dot a bar. Divergence del dot a bar, which is equals to del of del dot a bar minus del square a bar, which is required R reaches. Concentrate on the procedure, then it is very simple and easy. Therefore, del cross of del cross a bar is equals to del of del dot a bar minus del square a bar. Minus del square a bar, which is the required one. Yes, let us see the next theorem. You remember that this is nothing but divergence of a bar, del a bar, del dot a bar. So this completes the proof of the theorem. Next theorem. The statement of next theorem is, next theorem, curl of grad phi is equals to zero. Curl of grad phi is equals to zero. Curl of grad phi is equals to zero. So we know that grad phi. What is grad phi? Grad phi is equals to, we know that grad phi is equals to I bar into dou phi by dou x plus z bar into dou phi by dou y plus k bar into dou phi by dou z. Dou phi by dou z. So let it be. Now curl of grad phi. What is the formula for curl? Mod I bar j bar k bar do by do x, do by do y, do by do z. In grad phi, coefficient of I bar, do phi by do x. Coefficient of z bar, do phi by do y. Coefficient of k bar, do phi by do z. Let us expand the determinant I bar into do square phi by do y do z minus do square pi by do y do z, do y do z minus j bar into, by removing the column and row where j bar lies, do by do x of do square pi by do x do z minus do square pi by do x do z plus k bar into do square pi by do x do y, do square pi by do x do y minus do square pi by do x do y. You observe that every term is same with opposite signs. Every term is same with opposite signs. You get zero every term. So you observe that curl of grad phi is equals to zero. Therefore we conclude that curl of grad phi is equals to 0. This completes the proof. And take a note point. Take a note point. We know that if curl F is equals to, or curl of F bar is equals to 0, curl of F bar is equals to 0, then we say that F bar is irrotational. Then we say that F bar is irrotational. Yes, what is irrotational vector? If curl F bar is equals to 0, then F bar is irrotational vector. Here, curl of grad phi is equals to 0. Curl of grad phi is equals to 0, which implies always grad phi is irrotational. Always grad phi is irrotational. Always grad phi is irrotational. Observe that grad phi, gradient of any scale or function, is always irrotational. Gradient of any scale or function is always irrotational. Let us see the next theorem. What is that? Divergence of curl F bar is equals to 0. Divergence of curl F bar is equals to 0. We know that curl F bar is equals to, mod determinant of I bar, J bar, K bar, dou by dou x, dou by dou y, dou by dou z, F1, F2, F3. Expand the determinant, I bar into dou F3 by dou y, minus dou F2 by dou z, minus J bar into dou F3 by dou x, minus dou F1 by dou z, plus K bar into dou F2 by dou x, minus dou F1 by dou y. Now, Div of curl F bar is equals to. Let us take this is equals to. Div of curl F bar is equals to dou by dou x of the first term, dou F3 by dou y, minus dou F2 by dou z, minus dou by dou y of second term, dou F3 by dou x, minus dou F1 by dou z, plus third term, dou by dou z of dou F2 by dou x, minus dou F1 by dou y. We know that if F bar is equals to F1 I bar plus F2 J bar plus F3 K bar, then div F bar is equals to, dou F1 by dou x plus dou F2 by dou y plus dou F3 by dou z. Please observe the definition. If F bar is equals to F1 I bar plus F2 J bar plus F3 K bar, then div F bar is equals to dou F1 by dou x plus dou F2 by dou y plus dou F3 by dou z. Now you observe here. Let this term is first term, second term and third term, like this, F1, F2, F3. Now divergence of that function is equals to dou by dou x of first term. Actually we have plus, but we have minus here, minus dou by dou y of second term plus dou by dou z of third term. Let us expand. Dou square F3 by dou x dou y, minus dou square F2 by dou x dou z, minus dou square F3 by dou x dou y, plus dou square F1 by dou y dou z, plus dou square F2 by dou x dou z, minus dou square F1 by dou z dou x. Observe that we have 6 terms. 3 terms are positive, 3 terms are negative. Dou square F3 by dou x dou y minus dou square F3 by dou x dou y. Positive term and negative term, they get cancelled. Minus dou square F2 by dou x dou z minus dou square f2 by plus dou square f2 by dou x dou z. And you observe that dou square f1 by dou y dou z minus dou square f1 by dou y dou z. So finally you get 0. Finally you get 0. What is the required one? The same. Hence we conclude that therefore divergence of curl f bar is equals to 0. This completes the proof. And take a note point here. We know that if div f bar is equals to 0, then we say that f bar is solenoidal. Then we say that f bar is solenoidal vector. We know that div f bar is equals to 0, then f bar is known as solenoidal vector. Here you observe that from the theorem we have div of curl f bar is equals to 0. Div of curl f bar is equals to 0. Curl f bar is equals to 0. It means curl f bar is solenoidal. Curl f bar is solenoidal. You observe that. This is true for every case. In the previous theorem, we learned that gradient of any vector is always irrotational. Curl of any vector is always solenoidal. Observe that. Practice these three theorems. All the three theorems are very, very important. The first theorem is important for 10 marks, and these two theorems are important for 5 marks. Keep learning.